How can you figure out how many Fridays are included between two dates? This question was raised by Hussein, who wrote, "Please help me find a formula that counts the number of Fridays passed in a month till today."
For example, if our start date is 3rd of December 2018 and our end date is 22nd of December 2018,
the answer should be 3. What do you think? How can we solve this?
In Excel, we don't directly have a formula that calculates the number of Fridays between two dates, but we can use the existing functions and formulas to get the result that we want. One formula that gives us the number of days between two dates, super simple formula, is just to deduct them from one another. So I'm going to go to end date minus start date, and this way I can get the number of days that are between these two dates. Now remember, dates are just numbers in Excel, so if I switch the formatting from date to general, I see the number that's associated with this date. And they start counting from the 1st of January 1900. So if I switch this to 1 and I switch back the format to date, we can see 1st of January 1900. So let me just press Ctrl Z to go back to what I had. We have another formula that also helps us to calculate the number of days between two dates and exclude Fridays, or basically exclude certain days from our calculation. And that's called the network days formula. Now, network days originally assumed that the days it should exclude are the weekends, right? So the original network days formula just requires the start date and the end date, and it automatically excludes weekends. And it assumes that weekends are Saturdays and Sundays. But since Excel 2010, we have a new formula that is called Network Days INTL, so Network Days International, and we can actually define the type of weekend that we have in our country. So start date, that's the same. End date is right here. Now for weekend, we can pick Saturday, Sunday, or we can scroll down here and pick Friday only. If you wanted to exclude, for example, Mondays only, we would select 12 here. But in this case, we're going to select 16. What this does is it counts the number of days between the two dates and it excludes Fridays. Now I can use the information from these two to calculate how many Fridays I have. But there's one thing I have to be careful with, and that's what these days actually include and exclude. So basically, when I get the difference between these two dates, do I include the start date and the end date? Or is one of them or both of them excluded, right? So that's something we have to take care of before we end up deducting one from the other. So to check that out, let's just restrict our date range to a smaller one so we can just quickly take a look at calendar and find out what's included and excluded. So I'm going to switch that to the 6th, right? So that's from Monday the 3rd to the 6th. That's the Thursday. So there's no Friday included. And look at my results. I get different answers. So how many days between these two dates? I get 3. So 1, 2, 3, right? So one of these days is not included. It's excluding the start date. So it counts 1, 2, 3. Whereas this one, the network days, includes both the start date and the end date, right? So to be able to compare them to one another, I need to make an adjustment. So I'm going to add a 1 to this. So in the first case, I'm also including the start and the end dates. Now, if I wanted to calculate how many Fridays are between these two dates, well, I have all the information I need, right? I have how many days are in between these two. I have how many days are between these two, but exclude Fridays. So all I have to do is do this minus this. That's my answer. So if I switch this to the 8th of December, I get 1, right? So from the 3rd to the 8th, there's 1 Friday. And if I switch this to the 22nd of December, I get 3, right? So that's 1 Friday, 2 and 3 in here. Now I could write this as just one formula. So that's going to be end date minus start date. I'm going to add the 1 to this minus the network date international start, end, and 16 to exclude Fridays from that. Now I get a date because Excel thinks I want a date. I don't, I just want a number, so I'm going to switch that to the general format. I can also take a look at a bigger timeline, so let's just switch that to 2019, and let's look at January 31st. I get 8 Fridays between the two. Now I have the January calendar hidden in there. Let's just go to the selection pane and unhide my picture. And let's take a look. So that's between the 3rd and the 31st. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 Fridays are included between these two dates.
The network days formula, together with the other date formulas, are one of the formulas I cover in my free ebook that's called Top 10 Essential Excel Formulas to Work Smarter. It's an absolutely free ebook, so if you're interested to get a copy of it, jump over to my website, register, and grab your copy. The link to it is in the description of this video. Now, as always, if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and if you'd like to get more tips and tricks, consider subscribing.